We'd just like to get everybody's attention if we could. Really appreciate everybody that's here today. Appreciate your prayers for the family as they're gathered around for this homegoing service. We pray to lift up our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ most of all, and then next would be Miss Carolyn. And in that, I got a little bit I want to share before we have our prayer. But I share with you just a little bit some of my first experience eating around Miss Carolyn's table. I didn't know what lasagna was. We didn't have lasagna. We didn't have a meal in one plate, in one bowl. Y'all heard me yet? We got sitting there, though, and me and Ida and Mr. Johnson, Miss Johnson. She is always Miss Johnson to me. Even though Mr. Johnson's been gone, she's still Miss Johnson to me. We're sitting there, though, and she had it all fixed, a fine meal. But she wound up, as we got started, she said, whoever gets the leaf is going to have to wash the dishes. I had done saw something in my plate. And I was sitting there by a window that was by them old oak trees by the pack house out the back. And the chickens scratching in the yard, and I wondered if my leaf had come out from under that oak tree out there. But it was a bay leaf. So I question that. We were taught that you eat what's put before you. You don't question it, you know. You don't want to insult nobody. But it was a blessing. It's been a blessing. She was like a second mama to me. I was sharing with some while ago. I was blessed to be able to stand at my daddy's. I was blessed to be able to stand at Mr. Johnson's. But it's been tougher with my second mama. So if you all will this morning, I really desire your prayers. This rock that you see up here is a little bit of an example of Miss Carolyn. You probably see it and wonder what in the world that's doing up there. She was a nosy person. Would y'all believe that? Now, see, I'm her son-in-law, so I can tell y'all the truth, and I can get by with it. Y'all can't. But she was a nosy person and kind of liked to plunder just a little bit. And they had got her some gifts in Christmas future, and she'd get into them. She'd already, when they get there to open it up, she'd already know what they got her. So I think it was Lisa, and I don't remember which one, whether it was Ida, which ones had a part in it. But they decided to get one over on Mama, and they even told Mr. Johnson. He knew all about it. Never said a word. They wrapped that knocker up, got it and put it inside, and she... At that time, all it was a rock. They fixed it up after the fact like this here. But she shake that thing around, and Mr. Johnson was watching. He told me all about it, said it, son, I was about to roll out the seat watching her shake that thing. Said she couldn't figure it out, and said she went back and got it again, shaking it the second time, figuring out what turned it one side, and said, I just can't figure this one out, buddy. Said, she wound up and opened it up anyhow. She couldn't wait to Christmas. And she found her a rock. So that's what that rock's doing up there on that. But I really appreciate you all's prayers today and really appreciate each one coming. This really shows you what kind of a family that she has. And we'll go to the Lord in a word of prayer. Just pray for each of us as we go through this and the days to come. Father, we love you this morning, Lord. We just pray that you reach down, and we thank you for the breeze, Lord, but we ask you keep your hand on it, that it do not blow the flowers and everything away. Lord, we thank you for the family, Lord, and we pray even now that through your precious Holy Spirit, Lord, that you become very real and very evident, and Father, that let this time be a time of good memories. Flood them back, Father. And Father, let us just have a precious home going for a wonderful sister, mother, aunt, a friend, wherever she may have fit in each of the lives here. Let us just have a good time. That's what Miss Carolyn would want, Lord. She would want us to enjoy this time. Forgive us of where we fail you, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen.
I'm kind of home. which I've never seen before. No sad goodbyes would there be spoken, 'cause time won't matter anymore.
Amen. No more racing.
Beulah land, I'm longing for you, and someday
Johnson's Bible, and I prayed and I was searching scripture, and I had one of the hardest times of settling on scripture of any service that I've ever done. And I don't know whether the Lord's wanting to speak to somebody this morning or this evening or whatever it is. It may be that serious with God that there may be somebody here that really need to hear that God is real, and death is real, but life is real too. And life, if we know the Lord, is for eternity. And just pray as I read this. A good part of what I'll share today, Miss Johnson actually had underlined the very last part that I will share. She had it all lined up. And it took me a little to kind of get it together and put it together to kind of understand where she was going. Some of it is where she went through the other night, how the Lord just blessed her to be able to honor exactly what she wanted. Her children honored her, even though they may, I know with no doubt it was very hard, but their children honored what their mother wanted. And God honored her to within about 3.5 to 4 hours. She went from walking over to Ann and them's house to walking in glory. So that was an awesome blessing for a child of God. And that's what she wanted. That's how she wanted to leave this world. So in that, as I read this scripture, I'd like for you to really think about some of the things that even while she was laying on the bed that she was fixing to be experiencing. And I want us to really realize that sometimes, you know, we get around our families and we say they don't understand. They don't hear a thing. They can't feel nothing. They could walk up there and they could lay their hand on their mama's leg or touch her foot, and you could watch her blood pressure come up. Her heartbeat would rise up. Don't tell me they don't know when family touches them. Amen? They know. She knew her family. Every one of her children was right there. And that gave her peace. And she had that peace that passes all understanding. Thank God, God was in the midst of it. He carried her children. The Lord let her children be there, and He gave them the strength to honor. Today is Revelation chapter 21. And old John, man of God, he said, "And I saw a new heaven and a new earth." For the first heaven and the first earth was passed away. I really believe Miss Johnson began to see. She knew that she had been a little sickly, but she didn't know when her time was coming. Thank God we none know it. Doctors may think, and I'm not putting doctors down, but there's no expiration date on nobody's tooth. Thank God it's in the hand of God. Amen. But I really believe God gave her peace to walk through that hour that she walked through, because there were no trouble on her. She struggled a little bit for a little breath, but other than that, she went as peaceful as anybody I've ever seen in my life. He said, "I saw a new heaven and a new earth, and the first heaven were passed away, and there was no more sea. And I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down from God out of heaven, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, Behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and He will dwell with them, and they shall be His people, and God Himself shall be with them and be their God. And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things are passed away." We've not made it to heaven yet, church, family, friends. We're still in a fallen world. We are a fallen creature in a fallen world. There are things that's going on we cannot help. But wouldn't it be a blessing that we could have the blessed assurance of our God that when it come our time to pass over, we could be at peace, perfect peace. Perfect peace. That no matter what the world's in, she was not worried about what was going on in the world. She was not worried about her children. Her children was there. She knew her children would be all right. Because I'm going to share with you where she put them. It's real. "And He that sat upon the throne and said, Behold, I make all things new. And He said unto me, Write, for these words are true and faithful. And He said unto me, It is done. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of water of life freely." If you're here today and don't know the Lord, it don't cost you a thing in the world. All you got to do is call out. You call out from a broken heart and a contrite spirit and ask God to come into your heart, and He'll set you free. And He won't set you free just today. He'll set you free forever. We have to realize they are choices. Jesus died. Easter's coming. Jesus died to give us a choice. Miss Johnson left a way to give us hope. We read these things. We see our family pass on, but it's a blessing when you can be there and to see that the hand of God was very prevalent. Philippians chapter 4, verse 1. This is personally to the children right here. It applies to everyone that's here. It applies to the friends, the family. But to the children, I would really like for you all to listen up. This is from Mama. I'm going to redo old Paul's words a little bit just for you all. It says, therefore, my brethren, I want to say my children. This is from Mama. Therefore, my children, dearly beloved and longed for, my joy, my crown, so stand fast. You are still today her joy. You were her joy while she is living. You are her joy while she's living now forevermore. Amen. Let me just share just a little further. You are my joy, my crown. What do we do with our crown when we meet our Lord? Where did she lay, y'all, children? She carried you while she is here. She's done everything she can do. But family, friends, she's laid you at the Master's feet. My joy, my crown. So stand fast. Where do you stand? Was Mama always right? No, she weren't. Was Mama perfect? No, she weren't. I'm not here to lift her up or to run her down. But you cannot preach one soul into heaven. As Jesus told Nicodemus, you must be born again. You must come to a point in your life that the old man has got to die and a new man be born again. Stand fast in Jesus. Don't let the world mess you up. Don't get your eyes caught up and think all things are bad. He said, I am Alpha and Omega. He was in the beginning. When this all's over, he's going to be in the end. And if you're born again, he's going to be there to call you home. Stand fast in the Lord, my dearly beloved children. Verse 4. Said, rejoice in the Lord. How do you rejoice in a time like this? If they cannot rejoice here this morning, there's something wrong. Because they know where Mama's at. They saw their Mama leave this world. They saw the peace that God granted. Amen? The only rejoice we can get is to know without a shadow of a doubt who's got us. I can't save myself, so in other words, I can't even keep myself. I have to ask the Lord every day of my life to forgive me of shortcomings and sins that I do. Stand fast in the Lord. Rejoice in the Lord, and again I say rejoice. Let your moderation be known unto all men. Don't hide him. Tell somebody. Tell somebody why you can walk through this time. When you look back and you'll see you weren't walking. You weren't able to even sit here. The precious Holy Spirit was carrying you as you come in here today. He'll carry you as you walk out tonight. He'll lay with you tonight and talk to you all night. If you need him, all you got to do is call out. He's real. Be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known unto God. Talk to me all you want. That's what Mama would say. Talk to me all you want. Tell me all your troubles. But the one I want you to put first is the one that's still going to have you while I'm gone. I want you to seek the Lord, family. I want you to trust the Lord. I want you to carry your joys to the Lord. But I want you to carry your sorrows to Him too. And believe Him that He can help you. It says, and the peace of God which passes all understanding shall keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. Where did Mama lay you? Friends and family, all that's come today, there's not a doubt in my mind. If she could tell you anything, she'd tell you it's real. It's real. She passed so easy. So do pray for one another. Do pray for our family that's sitting right here. lift them up. And we pray even now as we go to close this at this time, one more song and prayer, that the Lord just bring them precious memories. Times of sitting around when Mama wouldn't let you, she'd call you there and you'd have to watch that TV with them old preachers whether you liked it or not. Right? There's some seeds being planted. Mama knowed what she was doing. Somebody's got to be Mama. We can't always be best friends. She was Mama. She knowed what she was doing. So as we, Brother Carl, before the last song, if you would, brother. There will be food at Yeoman's Chapel if you all would like to go by and be with the family and have a time of food and fellowship. When we leave here, if you will, just go back by the church.
I got called earlier today. Because I will admit to everybody here, it's a beautiful thing to see all her friends here. But I got called and asked if I would do the closing prayer. And as Brother Jamey shared about the rock, I've got to share one thing because she got the last one on me. She called me one time as I was out running an errand, and she said, "Hey, will you bring me home a Reese cup?" And I said, "Yep." So I stopped, and I knew what that meant. It meant a bag of Reese's. Didn't mean a Reese cup. So I picked up a Reese cup, and I picked up a bag. I walked in her house, and Ann was there, and I handed her the a Reese cup. One. And you know how difficult it is to find a single packed Reese cup? The look I got, and I have to admit, I am her favorite Yankee son-in-law. But the look I got, it's a wonder I didn't poof into a pile of ashes. And then I picked the bag from behind my back and handed it to her, and all was well. She was a beautiful woman. She was my mother-in-law. I love her. But she got me because the day she passed was my birthday. So I will not forget. And I know by the look of the crowd, neither will you. So will you join me in a closing prayer? Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this life and this example, this mother, this friend, this sister, this wife, that we all have had a part of her life. And I pray and believe that she touched each and every one of us here. Yes. And that we will never forget her. And we will meet her again one day and rejoice at that time. I pray that you be with us. John and the daughters, Lord, touch each and every one of them. Give them peace. Yes. And the rest of the brother-in-laws, Lord. Even though I'm the favorite, we pray that you'll touch them. I ask these things in Jesus' holy, precious name. Amen. Thank you, brother.
If I had only known the last time would be the last time, I would have put off all the things I had to do. I would have stayed a little longer, held on a little tighter. Now what I'd give for one more day with you. Cause there's a wound here in my heart where something's missing, and they tell me that it's gonna heal with time. But I know you're in a place where all your wounds have been erased, and knowing yours are healed is healing mine. The only scars in heaven that won't belong to me and you. There'll be no such thing as broken, and all the old will be made new. And the thought that makes me smile now, even as the tears fall down, is that the only scars in heaven are on the hands that hold you now. I know the road you walked was anything but easy. You picked up your share of scars along the way. Oh, but now you're standing in the sun. You fought your fight and your race is run. The pain is all a million miles away. The only scars in heaven, it won't belong to me and you. There'll be no such thing as broken, and all the old will be made new. And the thought that makes me smile now, even as the tears fall down, is that the only scars in heaven, yeah, are on the hands that hold you now. Not a day goes by that I don't see you. You live on in all the better parts of me. Until I'm standing with you in the sun, I'll fight this fight and this race I'll run. Until I finally see what you can see. Oh, the only scars in heaven, they won't belong to me and you. There'll be no such thing as broken, and all the old will be made new. And the thought that makes me smile now, and even as the tears fall down, is that the only scars in heaven on the hands that hold you now.